So what was the uniqueness of Indian National Movement? It was indeed one of the biggest mass movement and perhaps the only example wherein a democratic or a semi-democratic structure was being replaced. So putting things into perspective, it was one such movement where power was not seized in a single revolution. There were peasants' revolt, there were tribal uprising, there was first war of independence as we proudly call it. So there was no single revolution which was responsible for gaining independence. Revolution for independence was built through a prolonged popular struggle at moral level, individual level, political and ideological level. The reserves for the counter-hegemony were built over the years through progressive stages. Prior to the formation of Congress, there was the Indian Renaissance, social reform movement. Then there were phases in the leadership of Congress. Well, the active phases were alternated with the passive phases. The movement was, for some time, it was also in the passive form. As we say, the struggle, truce struggle strategy of Mahatma Gandhi, it was one of the master stroke in the national movement because he accepted the fact that the energies of masses cannot always be used for revolution. It has to be used for some constructive purposes also, so as to sustain the movement for a longer period of time. The movement explained how the constitutional space provided by the existing structure can be used against it without being co-opted. So we were basically opposing the Britishers, but within the constitutional domain, within the laws set by those Britishers itself. We were opposed to the laws, but we were compliant with them so that minimum hurt, or as we say, the philosophy of non-violence, was adhered to in letter and in spirit. There was simultaneous use of constitutional and non-constitutional struggles. So this is yet another unique feature of our national movement. There were leaders like Bhatukeshwar Dutt, Bhagat Singh, Ashfaq Ullah Khan, Ram Pratap Bismil. And there were leaders like Motilal Nehru, Dadabhai Nauroji, Mahatma Gandhi, Pandit Nehru, Sardar Patel. So there were all kinds of leaders who in their own ideological domain fought against the Britishers, and their efforts yielded results. Speaking about Congress, so Congress was not a party but a movement. There were all political trends from left to right in the Congress party. There were rich, there were poor, there were intellectual classes, there were masses, there were women, there were men, there were students. Everybody was a part of Congress, and this gave Congress a property of a movement and not a property of a political party. So discussing some more core features of our national movement, basically our national movement was based on certain values and ideals, and these ideals were based on a broad socio-economic and political vision vis-a-vis secularism, civil liberty, democracy, egalitarian social order, and so on. Our national movement popularized some democratic values like representative government and adult franchise, which was unique. Well, a country like India, which gained independence in the year 1947, no one would have thought that it would grant universal adult suffrage to its citizen and adopt a democratic form of government. So talking about the economic vision of our nationalist leader, so our nationalist leader envisioned the development of India through an indigenous industrialization and capital which was funded through Indians. Well, so there was also a pro-poor orientation in our national struggle, yet another feature of our national struggle. From the very beginning itself, this pro-poor orientation existed, and it strengthened with the advent of Gandhiji, and it gave rise to a socialist outlook. For example, the agrarian reforms, they were mainly aimed at reducing the hardships faced by the peasantry, which were ipso facto the poor class during those times. However, socialism was never the official goal of Indian National Congress. Congress was not a party but a movement. So there were socialists, there were other people who leaned towards other political ideology. So socialists never became a political goal or ideology of Indian National Congress. Our national movement was based on secularism and it opposed communalism, and there are enough evidences for that. And the last but not the least, another important feature was that our national movement, that is India's national movement, was supported by a large number of Englishmen, as the movement was based on the ideology that hate British imperialism and not British people. So there is a catch here. British supported Indian national movement because our national movement was against a British imperial structure and not against British people prima facie. Well, so these were some basic unique features of our national movements. Stay tuned for more such audios. Thank you.